Good morning and welcome. The priest's intentions for this morning's Mass is for John Marshall by his mother, Vincenzia. Please remember to silence your electronic devices at this time. Thank you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to the table of the Lord. As we come together as God's children, and it's sure good to be back. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Spirit dwells and lives in us. And now we come to this altar of sacrifice to celebrate all that God has done for us. May we call upon that God who is all loving, caring, and merciful. I confess.
My fault and my fault and my wrongs are yours' fault.
Hey, mighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
My friends, let us pray. Grant me, pray, O Lord, that as we celebrate in mystery the solemnities of your Son's resurrection, so too we may be worthy to rejoice at his coming with all the saints. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After Paul's escorts had taken him to Athens, they came away with instructions for Silas and Timothy to join him as soon as possible. Then Paul stood up at the Areopagus and said, "You Athenians, I see that in every respect you are very religious. For as I walked around looking carefully at your shrines, I even discovered an altar inscribed to an unknown god. What therefore you unknowingly worship, I proclaim to you, the God who made the world and all that is in it. The Lord of heaven and earth does not dwell in sanctuaries made by human hands, nor is he served by human hands because he needs anything. Rather, it is he who gives to everyone life and breath and everything. He made from one the whole human race to dwell on the entire surface of the earth, and he fixed the ordered seasons and the boundaries of their regions so that people might seek God, even perhaps grope for him and find him, though indeed he is not far from any one of us. For in him we live and move and have our being. As even some of your poets have said, for we too are his offspring. Since therefore we are the offspring of God, we ought not to think that the divinity is like an image fashioned from gold, silver, or stone by human art and imagination. God has overlooked the times of ignorance, but now he demands that all people everywhere repent, because he has established a day on which he will judge the world with justice through a man he has appointed. And he has provided confirmation for all by raising him from the dead." When they heard about resurrection of the dead, some began to scoff, but others said, "We should like to hear you on this some other time." And so Paul left them, but some did join him and became believers. Among them were Dionysus, a member of the court of Areopagus, a woman named Danaris, and others with them. After this, he left Athens and went to Corinth. The word of the Lord. The responsorial psalm, "Heaven and Earth are full of your glory."
Heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the heights. Praise him, all you his angels. Praise him, all you his hosts.
Heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Let the kings of the earth and all peoples, the princes and all the judges of the earth, young men too and maidens, old men and boys, above earth and heaven. He has lifted up the horn of his people. Be this his praise from all his faithful ones, from the children of Israel, the people close to him.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, I have much more to tell you, but you cannot bear it now. But when it comes, the Spirit of truth, he will guide you to all truth. He will not speak on his own, but he will speak what he hears and will declare to you the things that are coming. He will glorify me because he will take from what is mine and declare it to you. Everything that the Father has is mine. For this reason, I told you that he will take from what is mine and declare it to you. The Gospel of the Lord. God's gifts are everlasting. They're so bountiful. God continues to give to us through his Son, our Lord Jesus. And how blessed we are that we get to receive Jesus in the Holy Eucharist, a gift his precious body and blood. It's been a while, but we persevere with patience. Hopefully that my prayer has been throughout this whole time is that people would fall in love again with the Holy Eucharist, that they would truly appreciate it more, the gifts that God has given to how precious those gifts are. So we thank our God today. We thank Jesus for dying on the cross for our sins, for rising from the dead. And as this weekend we celebrate the Lord's ascension, his 40 days after the resurrection that he spent with the apostles, that he appeared to them as they ate together, we eat together with Jesus again. So Lord, help us to continue to have faith, trust, persevere, and knowing that no matter what we have to do, we will trust in the Lord. Please stand. As we gather in prayer today, we praise the Lord. We ask him blessings on all people, all individuals who have been affected by this virus, that Jesus will continue to give them hope and peace, and for their families who are separated from them, that the Lord will give them patience and hope and peace. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all the children who are being affected. Lord, bless them and protect them. Have them to be strong enough to resist and fight this virus. We pray to the Lord. And we thank you, Lord, for all those workers in the hospitals, the nurses, the doctors, the care facilities, all those who are taking care of those who are in need. Bless them, Lord, and protect them. We pray to the Lord.
We come today in thanksgiving for the opportunity of celebrating with Jesus. As he gives us the spirit of truth, we share that spirit with others. We pray to the Lord. Let us pause now and share with the Lord our own personal prayers and petitions. Personal prayers on our hearts and in our minds, we pray to the Lord. As Paul went forth to spread the gospel, the good news of Jesus, may we do the same today in our thoughts and in our words and in our prayers. We ask this through Christ our Lord. We offer you fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, become for us our bread of life. Bless you, O God of all creation, through your goodness. We have this wine that we offer you, fruit of the vine. Human hands become our spiritual. So with humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted to you, O Lord. May our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty. O God, who by this wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that, as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to claim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed. The integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy. Sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time that he was betrayed, he entered willingly into his passion. He took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this bread of life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered in one by the Holy Spirit. So remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Pope Francis, our Holy Father, Frank, our Bishop, and all the clergy. So remember all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who die in your mercy. All those who died because of this virus, they rest in peace. Help their families every week. So welcome them in the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, St. Paul, and all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Yes, Lord, we stand together as brothers and sisters in Christ. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, said your apostles, "Peace I leave you. My peace I give you. Look not down on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
Amen.
Let's now share a sign of Christ's loving peace, everyone. Of course, all. Lamb of God. takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
The body of Christ.
The body of Christ.
The body of Christ.
The body of Christ.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
The body of Christ.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Please stand. Let's do the spiritual communion prayer, please. My Jesus, I believe that you are really present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you to come into my soul. Though I cannot now receive you sacramentally, please come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Amen. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord. Lead those that you have imbued with heavenly mysteries. Pass from former ways to the newness of life. Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
your spirit. May Almighty God bless you. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Celebration is ended. Let us go in peace and love and honor, serve, and trust in the Lord. Have a blessed and holy day. Bring Christ to others. Thank you.
Praise the Lord.